deepest thanksgiving and gratitude, our Prime Minister.
Thank you, Father Toti, for the invitation. Sometimes, in this job, and being Prime Minister for the second time, I realize that there are no coincidences. Everything is prepared for us from above.
Yes.
Not always we see the signs, but they are there. So when Father Toti approached me, we were trying to arrange a phone call, and it could not, it didn't happen. And then yesterday, Father Toti explained what was the intention, and we could just easily squeeze it in the schedule. And that doesn't happen very, very often. So
thank you.
I'm very honored to be here. I'm very happy to be here with you. I think that when I see so many priests gathering, only good things can come out of it. And I'm very pleased to hear that you as Filipino priests come together frequently because you are so far away from home. In Aruba, we have an important presence of Filipino priests, Catholic priests, and we appreciate them very, very much. I see two of my favorite priests in Aruba here, Father Toti and Father Juancho. I think that COVID has taught us a lot of things. COVID has hit Aruba very hard. Aruba is a tourism island. We depend on tourism. Unfortunately, we used to have other economic pillars in Aruba, like the refinery, but we do not have that anymore. So tourism was the only economic pillar before COVID. And as you can imagine, the first people to stay away were the tourists. So we needed to close the borders, and that was a very, very important decision and a very difficult decision to take. However, the way that we could think, pull together on the island, come together, and then push towards recovery of our Aruba, it has helped us a lot. It was a very difficult period. I'm sure we all experienced it, perhaps differently, but still very difficult. Now in Aruba, we can see progress again. We are not 100% where we used to be. I don't think we want to be back at 100% where we used to be. I think we learned a lot. There are a lot of things that we need to change. Economically on the island, of course, but also our families, coming more together, dedicating more time to each other. That is something that we learned by force because we could not do anything else. But it's something very beautiful. If everything goes as planned, we will close this year with a 73% recuperation of our tourism. Wow. That is very good.
Yes.
This year we have a 13% economic growth. So it's going the right direction. We're not there yet, but economically we will get there next year. But I'm more concerned about the mental state of our people. Because economically we can go back to the levels we were before the pandemic, but we need to focus more on the peace of mind of our people. And I don't know yet if the COVID period has strengthened our faith or just the opposite with every individual in our countries. And that is something that I'm sure that you as priests consider as one of the challenges. One of the things we know is that people do not attend church anymore like before the pandemic. There are logical reasons for that, but I just hope it's just logistics and not losing the faith. Because now more than ever, we need to concentrate on that. If there's something that helped me and a lot of people around me during the pandemic was our faith. And you can doubt, of course, you know all about it, but at the end of the day, it was our faith and knowing that it will be okay. We will get back on track. And Aruba will be back where we were, at least with progress, economic development, and things like that. And now we want all our people to be there as well once we, and then we can surely say, you know, this too shall pass, and this too has passed. Mm-hmm. At the beginning of the pandemic, I was on press conferences every day at 7 o'clock in the evening, every night, giving information how it's going for the people not to panic and to give some perspective to the people. And to be very honest, there were some days, a lot of days, that I just was walking towards the press conference room, not knowing at all what to say or how to gather strength myself in order to portray a strong person, you know, and trying to keep everybody calm. Of course, prayer helps a lot. Like, you know, yes. I'm preaching to the choir, but it helped me a lot. We were, Sandra is my right hand in a lot of things that we do, and we had a difficult announcement to make 2 weeks ago. And Sandra told me, I don't have my rosary with me, but I had mine. So we could share the rosary, and that is where we gather our strength.
Yes.
That is where we gather our strength. So I'm very happy to be here. I'm very honored to be here. I wish you a good gathering, a very successful togetherness here. And I hope that we in Aruba can also experience the benefits that you can reap out of these gatherings. May God bless you all and continue doing the beautiful work that you are doing for us. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
May the good Lord bless and keep you. May the near or far away. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again.
Let's go on a picture with her.
Okay,
shot na po ng picture.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.